Number 5. Symphony of the Seas. As the cruise liner industry grew, so too did the desire to make them infinitely bigger and better than anything else out there. Thus was the case with the Symphony of the Sea, a ship that is almost 1,200 feet in length and does indeed hold the record for the largest cruise ship in the world, a title that was once held by its sister ship, the Harmony of the Seas. But the newer ship outclasses it, while also having a weight 1,000 tons more than its sister ship, with its total weight being over 228,000 tons. What's more, it has 18 total decks and a height of 238 feet in the air. It's meant to accompany a large amount of people while also accommodating them with a variety of activities and pleasures, including boardwalk, pool and sports zone, central park, royal promenade, entertainment place, youth zone, vitality, sports and fitness. The ship was completed in 2018 and cost $1.35 billion to make, as well as having a crew of 2,200 people on it. The Symphony of the Seas is available for booking and has traveled to many places across the hemispheres, including Barcelona, Florida, the Bahamas, and more. And what's more, the average rating for the ship and its cruises is a cool 4.6 out of 5 stars. Number 4. TI Class Supertanker. Built for launch in 2003, the TI-class supertanker is actually a set of ships: the TI Africa, the TI Asia, the TI Europe, and TI Oceania, all of which are still in service to this day, by the way. With a length of 1,246 feet and weighing 246,000 gross tons, they are truly massive supertankers, allowing them to carry large portions of oil across the world. The ships were designed and built by Hellespont Group, by Daewoo Shipbuilding and Marine Engineering of South Korea. They originally were named very differently, but then in 2004 they were all purchased and then renamed to fit their new owners. Specifically, they were bought by Euronav NV, a Belgian ship owner. Despite its size, the TI-class supertanker is known for its impressive speeds, including being able to reach 17.5 knots in the water when in ballast. However, despite its size and speed, there are certain canals that it cannot get through, including the newer locks on the Panama Canal and the Suez Canal, unless it goes in via ballast. Since their launch, two of the ships were converted into storage and offloading vessels. Number 3. Emma Maersk. Launched in 2006, the Emma Maersk is an E-class container ship, one of 8 from its line via the A.P. Moller Maersk Group. When it was launched in 2006, it was the largest container ship in the world, and it held that title until 2010. As a container ship, it would travel the world carrying vast amounts of cargo from one port to another, and its carrying capacity was 11,000 TEU. And in case you don't know, like I didn't, a TEU is a 22-foot equivalent unit, or a shipping container that lines the ports of various places all over. There was a rather famous run to the United Kingdom in 2006, where she was temporarily renamed the SS Santa, since she was bringing loads of Christmas presents to the country. Another thing that made the Maersk so special was that it was powered by the Wärtsilä 14RT Flex 96C engine, the world's largest single diesel unit. Thankfully, this engine has also been outfitted over the years to lessen the damage it does to the environment. The ship is still in service today, despite certain circumstances about her design, mainly regarding the diesel engine and the occasional controversy, including shipping garbage from China to Great Britain for recycling. The ship still ranks among some of the largest container ships in the world today. Number 2. Seawise Giant. A legend in the ship industry, the Seawise Giant is a now decommissioned vessel that was built back in 1974 by Sumitomo Heavy Industries in Japan and took 5 years to build before it could begin service in 1980. At the time, it was the largest ship ever with a length of 1,504 feet. But what sets it apart from many ships both then and now was that the Seawise Giant had the ability to displace 657,000 tons of weight. A record that still stands to this day. And to some, despite bigger ships being built in various avenues, it's still considered the biggest ship ever created in the world. And in terms of function, the Seawise Giant was a super tanker, or a massive oil tanker, one that did its job for many decades. However, despite its great carrying capacity, it was not the easiest ship to control and guide. Multiple ports all over the world as a result couldn't dock the ship, including those in the English Channel, the Suez Canal, or even the Panama Canal. However, she did serve her purpose, and during the Iran-Iraq War, she was sunk, but then salvaged, rebuilt, and allowed to maintain its work. The ship was eventually sold to Indian Shipbreakers in 2009, and then fully scrapped in 2010. Number 1. Prelude. The Prelude FLNG is defined as the world's largest floating liquefied natural gas platform, as well as the largest offshore facility that has ever been built by man. In terms of dimensions, the Prelude is 1,601 feet long, 243 feet wide, and at full capacity can weigh up to 600,000 tons. The Prelude was built in South Korea. However, it was a joint construction venture between companies Royal Dutch Shell, KOGAS, and INPEX, though it is owned by Shell. It was finished in 2013, and despite it being a ship, the Prelude is usually moored in one spot while it begins its operations in various areas of drilling. When that happens, it uses driven steel piles to keep it in place so it doesn't drift via the ocean's tides and currents. After being launched in 2013, it was built and added upon until it could begin drilling functions in 2016. It's so big and efficient that it's stated to be able to get 5.3 million tons of liquid and condensate per year. This includes 3.6 million tons of liquefied natural gas, 1.3 million tons of condensate, and 400,000 tons of liquefied petroleum gas out of the ground every year. It started its drilling operations 200 miles off the coast of Australia. Not only was the Prelude built to do hard labor, it was also designed to withstand a Category 5 storm, though there is room for a helicopter to land should it be required. The total cost of the Prelude FLNG was estimated to be upwards of $12.6 billion.